Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to print 4x6 and 8x10 images, etc., using the Windows Picture and Fax Viewer. So what you want to do is browse to the folder where you have the pictures that you want to print, and you can go ahead and right click on one of them and say Open With in the right click menu and choose the Windows Picture and Fax Viewer. This may not be available on all operating systems, but it's certainly in there for Windows XP or most XP installations. So here you'll get a preview of your image, and what you want to do is go down to the little print icon and click on that, and that brings up the photo printing wizard. We go ahead and click on next. Okay, and you can choose to just work with one photo, or you can click on the little boxes to check off other photos, or you can simply click on the button down here that says select all, or if you want to start over, of course you can click on clear all. But once you have the images selected, go ahead and click on next. Okay, and it will ask you what printer that you want to use. In this case it's an HP OfficeJet 6600. We'll go ahead and click next again, and this is where we're going to get our options. So we have full page, fax print, full page photo print. You can do a contact sheet where you can get up to 35 prints per page if you just want a little thumbnail reference of a whole bunch of images. But for most people, you're going to be looking at the 8x10, 5x7, or 4x6 options. It goes down to 3.5x5 and little wallet prints. But let's go ahead here and choose 4x6 cutout prints. Now, there's a difference here between cutout prints and album prints. Album prints will be oriented in the same way. It'll make sense the way they're, you know, the up and down will be normal. If you're flipping through an album, you would just take that 8.5x11 inch sheet and put it in an album and you'd be done. But here, in the 4x6 inch cutout prints, this is when you want to maximize the use of your 8.5x11 inch page. And you'll get, if you're using the same photograph, you'll get three copies of it, but one of the copies will be rotated, right? Which isn't something that you'd necessarily want in an album, but which totally won't bother you if you're just simply going to cut it out. Once it's cut out, you won't be able to tell what orientation it had on the page, and you won't really care, right? Now, normally you would get a print preview here that would show you the layout. For whatever reason on this system, that's not coming up, but what we would do is go ahead and, before we go ahead and click next, you can also choose the number of times to use each picture. So if you know that you want three copies of each picture, go ahead and do that, and the photo printing wizard will figure out, you know, how many pages are needed and create that number of pages. Okay. And then it's simple a matter of going ahead and clicking on next to start the printing process. Okay, and depending on your printer, you may get a further dialog or not, but in the general case, it would just start printing and give you a line showing progress, printing progress report kind of thing. I don't actually want to print these sample photos at the moment, so I'm not going to click next here in the video, but that would be the next step, and you would be done. All right, hopefully this explained everything that you need to know. Thanks for watching.